Hey guys, thanks for coming in tonight. Happy Tuesday. So happy you're here. We are going to continue on block 51 of the Splendid Sampler Quilt Along. A little bee, he's so cute. We drew his, we stitched, embroidered his little face on last night. So tonight all we have left is the English paper pieced flower out of seven little hexagons, and then we'll be done with him. I think it may actually take a little longer than tonight, but we're gonna go real quick and see if we can get it done. I don't know, that might be like stretching it a little, but I'm hoping we can do pretty well here. So getting close, almost finished. Last little bit on the bumblebee, block 51. If you want more info, you can go to thesplendidsampler.com. The book is on pre-order. I just ordered mine yesterday, so I can't wait for it to come out. And that is that. If you're new here, my name is Alyssa Thomas from Penguin and Fish, where we make lovely and quirky hand embroidery patterns and kits. I am the author of Sew and Stitch Embroidery and a fabric designer, and I'm here every weeknight at 9:30 p.m. Central. So thanks so much for coming in again, guys. I'm going to flip you around, and we will get going right away here. Okay. Here we are. So this is our little guy. So we have to completely prep these pieces yet. So I'm going to cut these out with my little paper scissors. Hopefully this doesn't take forever and ever. So we are going to cut these out. I printed it on a little bit of a thicker paper than printer paper. It's kind of not quite a tag board, but just kind of like a thicker paper, like a photo paper almost. So I'm just gonna quickly cut out these hexagons. So I printed it on a thicker paper because you do, with English paper piecing, you do want a nice edge. And this slightly thicker paper gives it a little nicer edge. And you know what? I wonder something. Oh, I don't have enough over here. I was thinking, I wonder if these are the same size as the Inchy Hexagon Club hexagons, because I have a few of those laying here, but they're in pretty rough shape. So we'll just cut these out, and I don't think I have enough. So I have my scrap bin here. We're going to just straight up pick some scraps for all these little hexies. Hey everyone, thanks for all y'all who are popping in here tonight. I'm getting excited to get this bumblebee close to finished. It's coming along. You know, it's that Saturday. On Saturday we had a little mini marathon, and we worked on this guy the whole time. I think the mini marathon was about 3 hours or so on Saturday. So we got a lot done. We got all of the English paper piecing done, and that was quite a bit for the bumblebee. You used your leftovers, Pam. I think that's exactly my plan. I'm down to leftovers in general, so we'll use those. Relieved my oh, you received your materials. Yay! How many more do you have left? I was wondering that before I came on tonight. I think it's, oh man, I'm almost scared to say. I think it's 5 after this one, but I think it might actually be 6 after this one. I'm going to glue baste these hexies, Amy, and that's because for the Inchy Hexagon Club, which we just sort of finished too, we made, you know, basically a pile of these flowers, like what we're going to do now, but we hand basted all of those, stitch based them all. So I thought, why not try the glue baste for these ones? And that's what we did a lot on the bee, like this whole second half of the body, that, you know, and then the rest of the piece that we started on Saturday. That was all, we did that all glue basting, and I think that was why it went quickly. I think some of that sew basting takes a while. It's cool. I love the sew basting because it feels so traditional and hand done. But you know what? let's go for speed. Yep, yeah, runs to find blue stick. So if you want, you can do the stitch basting too. That's perfectly fine. I mean, that's what we did for the entire Inchy Hexagon Club. So, all right, after I cut all these out, there's seven of them, I am going to take my little hole punch here and punch a little hole in it. That is going to, just right in the center or wherever I can, I don't know, they're kind of so small for this, I can barely fit. But this will help us be able to pop out the papers when we're done, especially since we're gluing them down. That might make it a lot more difficult to pull out compared to just the stitch basting. So that would maybe be a good idea. Oops, slid a little. Alright, two more. One, two, three, four. Uh-oh, wait, there's only six here. Aren't there seven? Oh, there's two here. Oh, did I punch these at the same time? I might have. Weird. Okay. And two more. It's hard to hold these tiny hexes. Oh, that one's kind of not centered. All right, so now I guess let's pick, we need seven little fabrics. And stuff in the table. So I think maybe some of these bright flowery ones are gonna be the way to go. So let's just grab a few. I'm just going to grab, you know, if we do seven different ones, I think that'd be kind of cute. So let's just see what we got. So we do have to have them kind of a little lighter because we have it's going to be placed right here. So it's got to, you know, we got to be able to see it off of there. This yellow. Ooh, this might not quite be big enough. So we need to, oh yeah, Hexies from the previous block worked for you. Oh yeah, so... if you have some of these papers left over, you could probably use those. This is pushing it, but I think we have just enough seam allowance around for this yellow, so I'm going to leave him out too. What else do we got? Ooh, let's do one of these crazy reds. Or, oh, it's not even red. It always appears kind of reddish. Ooh, maybe some of this kitty fabric. And then maybe that blends in too much, but it could be the center maybe. Yeah, that's just enough fabric. What else do we got? Oh, here we go. That's big enough. One, two, three, four, five. I'm just going to do all different because I think that's kind of fun. Five. That's assuming I could find more. Here's just straight up red. Six. Oh, here's some white. Maybe this one because we can get some of this blue in there. Six. Was that six? Two, four, six. Oh, wait, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. All right. What about that? How do we feel about that? I don't think everything else is pretty dark in here. I don't know. Let's do that. Yeah, all these are pretty dark. I do love this blue, but we have that a lot in the background. This green, we don't have enough of. That's just a salvage. All right. I think that's what we got right here. So let's do one hexy for each of these. Let's get these papers just out of my way here. So I'm going to put a dab of blue, and I am just using an acid-free, washable, non-toxic type glue stick. You can use an Elmer's little glue stick. I just happen to have this one, I don't know, UHU. I don't know why it's called that. Glue stick. So I'm going to, what about the pink? Oh, I don't think I had enough of the pink, but I was kind of looking for that. It's actually, what's funny is that it's not actually pink. It's actually, oh, we do have a little, I don't know. Oh, yeah, we do have enough. Here, let's pull that guy out. It's actually, red on white. The little zigzag, I do like that. And the orange, I saw a little triangle of the orange, but I don't think it was enough. Yeah, I don't think that's quite enough here. Well, let's double check. The orange with the The orange with the black stripe. Yeah, think I want a little more seam allowance than that. So since I have other choices here, I'm going to go with those. So maybe let's get rid of the blue, this kitty, because I think that's just a little too close to what we got going on there. So now we should have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, now we have 8. Oh, where'd this guy come from? We could do this little polka dot too. Maybe these? That's kind of cute. I think let's go with those. They're all kind of bright and shiny. So, all right, so we got kind of bright whites, yellows, orange. That should contrast this pretty well, I think, which is kind of what I'm going for. So, all right, we don't need the thread yet. So, all right, we have our 7 hexes. Let's trade spaces here. And I'm going to glue one onto each of the wrong sides of the fabric. And I'm just putting barely a dab. This is just so it stays in place while I cut out the fabric. And then I'm going to place it so I have, you know, about a quarter inch seam allowance all the way around. So even with these scraps, we have more than enough fabric. So I'm just going to go through all of these and glue them all down first. Just putting a tiny dab right in the middle. So trying to see how quick we can go through this. This one will be kind of weird. It'll have this weird red stripe kind of going through it. I can't pick these up off of the table. Here, I'll just get it with the glue. There we go. That worked great. I'm gonna do that again. Chunk. Needs a sound effect. All right, I think I'm gonna go in the white area. I'm gonna just go in the white where there's one funny little dot. So I think some of this blue, like floral, will maybe get to be too blue. So we'll keep it to the white. All right, 2 more here. This one maybe will get a little bit of these blue dots. Oop, I forgot about my glue pickup. Forgot about it already. We'll do it for this one. There we go. Extra fossils everywhere. Okie doke. Alright, so I'm going to just cover this up for a moment. So now I'm going to cut all these out, you know, almost in a circle. It can be blobby. It doesn't have to be a perfect seam allowance, but I am going to do kind of about maybe a hair less than a quarter of an inch from the edge. And, you know, you can see I'm just totally roughly going around this. There, that'll be perfectly fine. All right, getting some scraps, and I have still a lot of scraps left of that fabric. So if you guys are on my Bunny Live Stitch Along list, my emails, if you get those emails, I will be sending an email out tomorrow, so you guys can keep your eyes open for that. I'm hoping to do a little fun live thing tomorrow, so we'll see how that goes. All right, 4 more. Trying to speed through these. Again, you don't have to have your perfect seam allowances, so that's kind of nice. I don't have to bother taking time to making those all perfect. I like this red stripy fabric. I think it's so cute. It's one of my favorites still. They're all my favorite. And 1 more. Oh, I know, my huge. I think they're 8-inch, they might be 7-inch dressmaker shears. I love them. I mean, yes, it is kind of crazy big for these little hexies, but they cut like butter, and I love the sound that they make when they cut. I just really like using them. They feel good in my hand. So I've been, you know, even though it's a little overkill, I've been using them. So, all right, we're ready to go. 2, 4, 6, 7. I always feel like I'm going to lose one. So, all right, now comes the glue basting. So this is normally where what we did in the Inchy Hexy Club, we folded the edges over and stitched down each corner all the way around to hold everything in place. We're going to hold it in place with glue instead. So let's just see how this goes. I don't think I've glued hexes before, or glue-based hexes, so we'll just see if this works okay. I am kind of putting glue on the fabric. So I'm folding it over an edge, and then finger pressing the edge all the way over. We might have a little trouble getting these papers off, but we're gonna do our best. It is a Kai scissors. I'll put a link to it on the YouTube, but here I can. They're not cheap, but man, they are fancy nice. So here we are. It's a Kai 7230. Kai is K-A-I. It's awesome. You bought a pair of line, go, you show them. Love the scissors. Marjorie, so good. I don't know if a tornado actually touched down here. It was just a tornado watch. But holy cow, did we get some rain in a short amount of time yesterday. And then today we got snow, but like weird pellet snow. And it was, had such a brisk wind. And it is very windy. Like we, you know, probably in like a wind watch or something. I don't know if they have those, but it is so windy, like all day today. All right, so here's the last one. I don't know, I've never done the glue basting for these little hexes. We'll see how it goes. Oh, he needs a little bit more, it looks like. Put it on the tip instead. All right, so I definitely trust stitch basting this more. Like, I'm afraid that these are all gonna kind of pop off on me. So definitely I trust the stitch basting, but we're gonna give it a try. We're gonna glue them and stitch them together quick, so hopefully we'll be good. Oh, it's very windy up there in Forest Lake too. Yeah, super windy here. I'm in the, like, just outside Minneapolis. In the news, they showed lots of trees down by a lake. I believe it. I haven't driven around today, but this is definitely the type of wind. And you know how it always goes, we get like a massive amount of rain where the ground's not used to the rain yet. And then we get wind, and that's what downs the trees because their roots are wet and everything. I'm wondering if the water really got too far though, because I think the ground must be a little frozen yet, I would think. I don't know. It was so windy. I keep worrying that our tree is going to blow down in the front of our house. We had a big windstorm once, and a huge branch fell, and it was 3 a.m. I woke up right away, well, we both did, because the house just shook. You know, it's a major tree with a major branch that fell off, and it's pouring outside. So we got up. This isn't yesterday, but this is a year or so ago. We got up, it's pouring outside, and the tree branch, you know, it's like a trunk of a tree-sized tree branch. It landed. Our car was parked next to our house. Like, here's our house, and here's our car, and the tree's right here. It landed right in the middle of the house and the car, and we just, we got a little tiny scratch on the car, but that was it. That could have punched a hole in our house, easy, or smashed our car, and it happened to fall right in the middle. Kind of crazy. Oh, your local quilt shop has a glue pen that you can use for basting hexes. Haven't tried it, but she demonstrated so on Facebook Live. So that would work swell for this, because you know what? Big fat glue stick is not very accurate. A little glue pen could really get in here. And actually, you know, now that you said that, I think I might have a glue pen hiding somewhere. Ugh. Unfortunately, it is not out here, but I'm kind of envisioning it in my head, so I'm gonna have to look tonight. We won't need it anymore for this, though, and I'm not sure we have any more English paper piecing left for the splendid sampler, but I don't know. I'm gonna have to check now just to see. I have a vision of where this glue pencil thing pen might be. Here in Oakdale, the ladies' bulbs are coming up. Oh my goodness. Yeah, we're not that far along yet. Oh, this is some, got some fuzz from fabric on there. Our garlics, or not garlic, we have some spring onions that seem to want to start popping. Oh yeah, didn't go, you know, Joe, I didn't either. I wanted to. I felt, you know, I went outside for a little and I could tell that the sun was warm. You just couldn't tell because it was so blustery and windy. But you know, usually in winter when the sun's shining, you know it's just going to be so cold because it's, you know, if the sun's shining, that means there's no clouds, and the clouds are what kind of hold in the heat in winter. So the sun actually felt warm, so that was promising, but yeah, the wind was nuts. But yeah, I can't wait till it gets warm out. I'm just kind of squishing this flat on the table just to hopefully get that glue sticking a little bit more. I think this will be faster than thread basting, you know, just doing this part that I'm doing now will be faster, but I don't know. If I was doing this as a long-term project, like if I was doing a pile of hexies and I was basting them all first like this, I do not think I would glue. Yeah, plus we pooed Piglet Day, exactly. But I don't think I would use glue if I was planning on making a ton of hexies and then sewing them together later. I just don't think the glue would hold up. Although I'm no glue expert on English paper piecing, like I know a lot of people are, but I don't know. We're gonna stitch it together right away, so hopefully it's okay. You had severe weather last night too, so windy and lots of lightning. Ugh, yeah. Our lightning was a little scary yesterday too. Oh, didn't get to sleep after 2 a.m. No fun. I hate that. I had a day like that on Saturday, I think. No, it wasn't Saturday. Well, maybe it was. Yeah, I didn't sleep hardly at all from Saturday to Sunday. I got up way earlier just because I couldn't sleep at all, hardly, and man, that could sure change a day from being productive to absolutely incapable of doing anything. But I got to sleep in just a hair on Monday, so that helped me out a little bit. How many more of these do I have? Oh, I still have three. Listen to me, I'm like complaining about that I have three left when, you know, this would have taken us the entire time to stitch base these. I'm anxious to get them, stitching them together, that's why. You know what, I bet you, you know, I feel like I've seen this where people put a little paper clip on their hexies. I wonder if they do that when they glue baste it. So they glue baste it and then throw a little paper clip on, and maybe that holds all the glue and stuff in place. I don't know. Or I'm just making that up. I feel like I've seen that before. I don't know. All right, here is the last side of that one. Squish it. Oh, I got kind of a lot of white ones. That's okay. Whites and reds and one little yellow. Maybe we'll put the yellow in the middle and trade off whites and reds. That'd be kind of fun. We'll get to arrange all these next, and then we'll stitch them together. Then after we stitch them together, we still have to get them on the, we still have to stitch it, applique it to the bee. She has not pieced her top, as far as I know yet. She has started, I think she, last I heard, she still had to do block 100. I'll have to give her a call. And then she started, just kind of as a test, I think, that sashing that looks like the shadow, you know, that it was that example that they pitched. Maybe the Wonder Clips. Oh yeah, that'd be a good idea. Like if I I'm not too worried about the glue coming off now because I'm gonna glue it together right away, or I'm gonna stitch it together right away. But yeah, if I was hanging out and I knew I wasn't going to be stitching these together right away, then I would do something. I would put a Wonder Clip on or something. But yeah, no, she's getting that sashing on, that sashing to make it look like there's like a little shadow underneath each block. So I think she's maybe working on that. I don't think she has that done for all the blocks yet. We have a bunch of hexies cut out, but a lot bigger than these for a quilt. Are you doing a whole entire hexie quilt? Yeah, the bigger hexies clearly would, you know, make that go faster. I don't think I've done that big of hexies. Like, I don't think I've done hexies bigger than about this big, the couple, the inch or so, I keep forgetting how these are measured. I think it's based on what one edges. So 1-inch hexies, which are really more like, you know, 1¾-inch hexies sort of things. I think that's the biggest I've done. So not that big. If you take the amount of times I've English paper pieced hexies, the Splendid Sampler has been about 80% of all my, actually, you know, probably about 92% of all the hexies I've ever done have been here. Especially since that Inchy Hexie Club one. And we had the So South one, those had bigger hexies. You're working on the sashing like your mom. Oh, cool. It looks really cool. Yeah, I thought it looked so neat in the photo of the example. I was almost thinking of doing that too, but I'm still going with my mashing it all together. But yeah, I think I'm excited to see what it looks like. So I'm going to just try the red, white look. See if we want to go with that. I don't know. I'm kind of okay with that. Let's try getting orange one down here, maybe like that. You know what, maybe we should be arranging it on here so we can see what it looks like. Where's this place in the picture? Yeah, so this part is kind of right underneath his chin. I mean, I don't know, looks okay to me. What's funny is I think because I have those whites, it doesn't pop out as much as I thought it would, which is kind of neat. I kind of like it blending in with all of this a little bit. So, all right, you know what? We got to choose something. So let's do this. I'm going to just leave them in that position. I think these would probably be, I have my blue thread out here, but I think I'll use this gray. I think that'll look a little bit better for this. I think the flowers applicate on, even though I would love the grandmother's flower garden for the hexies. Oh, fun. Yeah, someday it would be cool to do a whole quilt that's just hexies stitched together. That would be kind of crazy fun. All right, so I think I'll run this through the beeswax again, because why not? Oh, wait, I forgot. For English paper piecing, I think I like my thread a little shorter. This is maybe a little long. A little snippet right there. All right, let me tie a knot first. And, oops. I can't do that little in my hand, just twisty knot thing. I'm gonna have to watch a YouTube video on that and figure that out. Feel weird tying it out this way. All right, let's run it through beeswax because we're playing around with that idea. I don't know if it works, but we're testing it. Oh, I have the iron, but let's do it without the iron. All right, so let's, you know, we'll grab a center and let's just stitch one to the center and we'll start there. So we can do the knicker knot again. That'll be fun. So the other trick is we are going to be a little, the edges are more, let's get in focus here. The edges are sharper because we glued them instead of them being a little flappy with the stitch. So I'm trying to avoid stitching through the paper, so it's going to be even a little harder to do that. So, all right, the knicker knot. This adds an extra little knot at the points there. I'm trying to keep it in focus here. There we go. So the knicker knot, you've gone through once with the needle, and now I'm going through again, straight through the point. Ooh, now I can't do it. There we go. And then you have the thread coming out of the fabric, and then you have the thread coming out of the eye of the needle. So the thread that's coming out of the fabric, I'm going underneath the needle and to the left, and then I'm just kind of bringing it to the back and holding it down. And then with the pieces of thread that are coming out of the eye of the needle, I'm going from left to right underneath and holding it back. And then we'll pull that slowly, and that will make a little knot. Little knot at the end. It makes like a little figure eight. You can kind of see it there. And then you keep pulling and you got yourself a knot. So we learned that during the Inchy Hexie Club block, what was that, 36, I think, that we just finished. I think that's the one that we finished before this one, right? Yeah, I think so. We did Inchy Hexie Club and then moved on to this guy. That might not be right. That's what I have in my head, though. So, all right, now I'm just doing my little whip stitches. I'm really trying to not stitch through the paper because that will make it even more difficult to get our papers out. Do two more. Knicker knot. Joe, my quilt, I'm planning on being queen size so it can actually go on our bed. We have a queen size bed. And I kind of like my quilts to hang over a little bit more. Smiley face is cute. I like them hanging over a little bit more, so it might be a hair larger than a normal queen, just so we can have more hangover on our quilt. So all right, I'm going to do the knicker knot again, under and to the left, and then under and to the right. Okay, there we go. Our first two pieces are sewn together. How fun. All right, next piece is right here. So I'm going to sew it to this white piece first, and I'm going to just jump my thread to this side. If I have little jumps like that, it's not going to harm anything. So I'm going to start here so I can go both of these right at the same time instead of going from the middle out, just jumping over to here. So going through once, let's not get it stuck. Yeah, so we stitched his little face on last night, Cora. We had a little bit of time left, so thought we'd do a little embroidery on him. To stitch, I thought it was going to take the entire time to stitch around the edge here. But it really didn't take all that long, so we had time for embroidery. Will you have just one border to make a queen size? I'm still kind of deciding on that. So my design for the quilt, I want all of the blocks to be kind of this crazy mass of color and pattern and whatever right in the middle. So they're all going to touch. And, you know, if I have a blue, it's going to meld into another blue. I want it to be like this whole melded thing. And I know that's going to look totally crazy. So to counteract the crazy, I just want some big, I don't know necessarily solid, but some big one piece of fabric kind of borders, because that'll be like the calming moment of the quilt, so that the edges will stay calm and then your eye will go to all the crazy stuff going on in the middle, all the details and all the stuff from the middle. So that's my plan. So I think I am going to just do one border, but I don't know if the proportions end up being weird, like if it just looks too big when I lay it out, then maybe I'll do a double border or something. I don't know. Up in the air yet for sure, Joe. I'm not quite sure. I'm kind of waiting to make decisions until I get all these blocks done. That's why I'm just going nuts. I need to get these done. I'm like freaking out. Like, let's get these blocks done. I want to make the quilt. I'm getting antsy. All right, so we stitched the one side on, and we're putting right sides together too. I didn't mention that, but right sides together, and we stitched the one, and now we can stitch this one. And to do that, we kind of have to bend this paper. So you don't have to worry about that. It's okay to bend it. So I'm gonna go through that corner again, even though we're kind of at that corner, but I want to make it so that the red and yellow piece connect now, not just the white and the red pieces. All right, doing my knicker knots again. Oops, going around the wrong side there. All right, whip stitch this. I really like to get these all stitched tonight. I think when we were doing the Inchy Hexy Club, we weren't able to stitch all of the, I think we were only able to stitch like 5 at a time, and we have 7 here, but we are also hand basting those, so I think maybe we're a little faster tonight, and I'm trying to go really fast. So I'd like to hopefully finish this flower, and I'd like to at least press it and get, I'd love to get the papers out of it. And at least glue it to our background so it's all ready to stitch tomorrow. Oh, you love this, Marianne! You know, I'm really totally enjoying this block, too. It's kind of crazy. The colors I picked are kind of weird. They're like a little dark and blue, and, you know, they kind of blend into each other a little bit, but I'm kind of digging it still. All right, so those are our 3. They go right here. So next up is this white one. It goes right there. So again, I'm kind of stitching it to the outside ones first, and then stitching it to the center one. So all I have to do is remember that the white is, or not the white, the yellow is my center. As long as I remember that, then they'll all go in the right spot, which would be nice. All right, here's where I'm just leaping from the center to here again. I don't think there's anything wrong with a leap this small. This whole thing's going to have so many stitches, and it's going to be stitched down. I think a little leap's not going to hurt anything. Or a little jump, I suppose it's called a jump. All right, there's my little knot. Really trying to cruise through this tonight. Oh man, I don't really quite remember if I have 5 or 6 after this one. I think it may be 5, however, I'm not positive. Let me try and count them again. So there's Dedication Rose. That's the, Dedication Rose. There's that one with the heart in with the embroidery. There's the one with the hand that's embroidery. I have the bows to do, paper pieced. And I have that one block with the pointy bits and the circles that's kind of pieced. That's 5. That might be it. Can you think of a different one that I'm not thinking of? I think that might be it. So it might be 5. The yellow. Oh, you saw the yellow fabric at Bear Patch and Body Yard. This yellow fabric here. They have a bolt on their clients right now. Yeah, this is by Barry J, I think, is the person that does this yellow fabric. I think it's a few, I think it's from a little while ago, I'm not sure. Working on the hand block. Oh, cool. Just finished about 35 French knots. Oh my God. I'm not that far on mine. That hand block has that whole little like kind of sampler on the right side of it. Sampler of stitches almost. I'm not to that. I'm still in the hand area. All right. Flip it to the center again. Got to bend that one to make that Y seam work. Knicker knot in the center here again. I have a hunch I went through paper there, but we'll see. Some of these might be a little difficult to take out, but luckily I'm trying to do it all in one night, so the glue couldn't have, you know, glued itself down too much, I don't think, in this amount of time. time. So maybe it'll be easy to get the glue out. Oh yes, the center hexie. Yeah, I think it's by Barry J. She does cute work. After you got started, you started doing it. Yep. Oh, you haven't started the hand one yet. Maybe we do that one next. I'm kind of sticking to these hand-based ones, aren't I? I think it's just because they took a long time. So I do have some sewing machine ones left. Two of them, really. But all the rest are very much a lot of hand work, which is fine. It's nice not having to set up the sewing machine every night. You know, Marianne, I kind of miss getting the duplex too. It is kind of neat, though, that I can finish these time-heavy blocks a whole lot faster. Just because we aren't getting those new blocks. But I know it feels so weird. No new blocks. I don't get to say new block Thursday or new block Sunday anymore. It's weird. All right. Next up is this little red one. But hey, you know, it's coming out again when the book comes out, and that's going to come up real soon here, I bet. And I think they're going to have all new, they're going to have a pile of more bonus blocks I don't know if that's true or not, but I thought they said that they're going to have new bonus blocks for when they start up the stitch-along again. They're going to do a quilt-along or stitch-along or whatever. Or when the book comes out, they're going to do all the blocks again. So I think they'll have new bonus blocks, so we could do some of those, maybe. It'd be kind of fun. I might do my block again when it comes out. Block 11. We'll see. I haven't really thought that far ahead yet. We'll see what's on the docket then. Are the hexes supposed to touch? The hexes that I'm sewing now? Are all the hexes supposed to touch? Well, for this one, it's a hexy in the middle and then six around it, so I don't know. Yeah. They should all match up, I suppose. Alright. And we'll be doing all kinds of crafts on here with you. Yep, we'll be doing so many crafts. Oh, you like my Black 11? Oh, thanks, Judith. Yeah, that one was dedicated to all the doilies that my grandma used to make and stuff, and now I love making the doilies, like with her same thread and her needle and her actual thread. That was left behind using all that up. I'm really having fun doing that. The electronic version is about $7. Oh, the paperback is $23. So that's for the Splendid Sampler. Yeah, and it's on sale a little, not a ton right now, but it is on sale a little bit for the pre-sale. I'm not sure if that's just if you have Amazon Prime or what, but I think I did get, you know what, maybe it was still $23 after I got it. But yeah, I'm moving things around here. It's on Amazon right now. I'm excited to see it. I got a knot here, hold on. Most of the times you can just put your needle in the loop and it'll take care of it, but man, I'm feeling fumbly tonight. Hands on one side. There we go. There we go. So if you put it in the loop and pull on one of the strings, the knot should go all the way up to the needle, and then once it's really small, it can just pop right out. So I feel like in embroidery and in hand stitching, you get those knots a lot. All right, I'm confused here now. I think it's like this. Yeah. You get those knots a lot because what's happening is your thread is wrapping around the loop, and then holding it as a knot, kind of. You're going to do mine again with the sticky salvi. Oh, awesome. First one you traced. Oh, using the window. Oh, so that is a perfectly legitimate way of doing it. It's the way to get started, the way to get going with embroidery is just tracing it on your window for sure. I got another one of those loops. Maybe I should run it through the beeswax again now that it's getting all crazy again. This is why I liked shorter threads for the English paper piecing, because at this point it was getting all like squiggly. It's not twisty, it's just squiggly. I'm done with the Inchy Hexy Club. Oh, I mean, am I going to do it again when the new one comes out? That one I don't know if I'm going to be doing again. That took forever. But yeah, I finished that one. We spent a lot of time on it. I think two Saturdays ago. We worked on it quite a bit, but yep, it is all done. Done, done, done. Oh yeah, so I that one's done too. So I'm done with Sew South and the Inchy Hexagon Club now. The Inchy Hexagon Club. The Inchy Hexagon Club. We worked on it a lot of it. I think was it last week? That was kind of like the big deal of last week, maybe. I think I did it. Like a lot of it. I think I got done on the Saturday, and then it still took some time after that. I think that was 2 weeks ago, but I think it was last week. It's up on YouTube, though, so if you wanted to check that one out, it is up on YouTube. All right, there's my knot. All right, two more. Oh, man, we're getting close to timing. I don't know if we'll get it done. This is the, it's block 51, Be Happy by Katja Mark. It's the bumblebee one. Be happy. That's what it's called. Block 51, though. That's what we're working on. Yeah, it looks like my Inchy Hexagon Club, because we had to make one of these for the Inchy Hexagon Club. We had to make, like, a pile of these, actually. These little, hexy flowers. So, making another one for the little bee. He gets one tucked up right here. See? Right there, he gets one. Yep, this is for the bee. Yep, we haven't changed yet. This is still for the bee. The bee isn't finished. This is part of the bee. Extra little bee detail. I hope we get through thread. Daughter who has never embroidered just completed the hedgehog. Oh, yay! I love that. Oh, that's so cool. I love to hear when people give embroidery a go for the first time. Yep, I think some people did do this foundation piece, and what some people did that I thought was kind of cute is instead of piecing all of the stripes, they just did a striped fabric. Oh, and I think my mom might have, instead of piecing all these, I think she might have just cut strips and sewed all the strips together and then cut it out, which I thought was pretty smart too. But I'm trying to get that English paper piece experience of stitching odd shapes together. We did glue base most of them, though, just to get more precise edges, and I think that was really helpful through this body, the glue basting of it. And I did have to trim off, like, little slivers of paper here and there just to make them a little skinnier. Luckily, other people worked on them before I got that far, because other people were having a little issues that it would just keep getting wider and wider and wider, like their bee butt ended up way out here, because, you know, you add the thickness of the fabric in all those pieces, and all those, like, little millimeters add up to get you a fatter body, and especially with the stitch basting, the edges aren't so precise, because they're not glued in place to be super precise. I think I glue basted that apple under the apple tree one. That was quite a bit of English paper piecing, and I think that I all glue based just for the sake of the precision. Like, look, these are nice sharp edges because they're glued down. All right, one more after this. I just have to. We'll finish. I got this one straight away here, and then we got three edges on the next one instead of just two. Maybe I'll be able to not cut any more thread. That'd be kind of cool, even though it is getting a little unruly. Your daughter adopted a new kitten! Oh, she named him Elfie. Aww. I want a kitty. Elfie. That's cute. My friend was just telling me that she had neighbors who named their dogs Mabel and Rose. And I thought those were like two of the best dog names ever. Mabel and Rose. So cute. You haven't done this black yet, but I'm going to attempt it. Awesome. You've only done 11 blacks so far. That's awesome, Susan. You're on the road to doing them all. That's pretty cool. And you're way far ahead of all the people who haven't started yet. That'll start when the book comes out. That's pretty neat. Yeah, I definitely attempted blocks that I don't think I would have attempted if I hadn't been doing them here with you guys. Oh, I'd have been like, yeah, I don't know if I'm going to do that. Ooh, I kind of like this one with this funny little red bit towards the center. That's kind of cool. All right, this one has three sides because it's our last one. I hope we get to use the same thread for the whole thing. Let's see. It's 10:22 now. I would like to still try and get, you know, I don't know if you guys want to go a hair late tonight, but I'd still like to try and starch and press this and get these papers out, just because I'd like to starch and press it and then glue it down to here right away. Just kind of glue it in place to tack it down before we stitch it together. Basically exactly what we did with this. We glued it down first and then the next day. I just got a sympathy knot, like sympathy pain. Your trigger pulling knot. Oh, it worked! Oh, good! So, that's funny you call it a sympathy knot. Yeah, so those knots, they're pretty typical, or at least I've found that those are the types of knots that I get all the time. The ones where you get that weird, it's like a loop with a knot, and then it's like, ah, crap, how do I get that out? But yeah, usually if you stick your needle into that loop, jumping a little far here on the stitch, but usually if you put your needle in there and then pull on one or the other threads coming off of it, one will make the needle pull up to the knot, or the knot pull up to the needle, and the other one won't do anything. It'll just make it tighter. But then it'll go right up to the needle, that loop, and then you can pop it out. You missed the knicker knot. All right, here's the knicker knot. You go through, we've been doing it on the corners, and we just learned this the other day, so when we were working on the Inchy Hexy Club one. But you go through the corner, you go through it once, all the way through, and then you go through the corner again, but you don't bring your needle all the way through. So my needle is, it wants to keep focusing on that B down there. So my needle's not all the way through. So when you're in this position, you have a thread that's coming out of your fabric, right? And then you have the threads that are coming out of the needle. So the thread that's coming out of the fabric, you go underneath the front of your needle, and then this is the important part. You're going from the right to left underneath the needle, and then you're just kind of bringing it to the back and holding it there temporarily. And then with the part, oops, I just took the thread out of my needle. So hold on a sec. Back in, threading the needle left-handed or right-handed. I usually don't do it this way. So then the part that is the threads that are coming out of the needle, you bring that from left to right underneath the needle. So the part, let's just do that again, just because I stopped in the middle. So the part that's coming out of the fabric, thread that's coming out of the fabric from right to left underneath the needle and holding it back. And then the part that's coming out of the eye, you go from left to right underneath the needle, and then just kind of bring it to the back. Then you can pull it through slowly, and it makes kind of this figure eight sort of knot. There you can kind of see it. And that's your little knot. So that's the knicker knot. And then I just feel like it's a little extra security of having a knot in the corner there. And then you do the, I had to look on a YouTube thing, and we had to practice like 6 times before we got it, yeah, Susan, when we were doing the Inchy Hexy Club, but then we got it, or I think we do, I think we're doing it right. It's making a knot, so that's what I like. So here, we'll do it again. So we're at this corner. I'm going to go all the way through once, like my normal whip stitch, and then I'm going to go through again, stop with the needle in the middle, the part that's coming out, the thread that's coming out of the fabric, going from right to left underneath, and then hold it in back, and the part that's coming out of the eye, left to right underneath. And then you just pull it through, you got your little knot. And I do it at both corners, so I'm doing it at this corner I just did, and I'm going to do it pretty much in the same place on the corner of this next one. It's basically the same place, but we are going through different hexagons. All right, so here we go again. I went through once, and now again, so right to left underneath, left to right underneath. All right, this is our last straightaway. You know what? I think I'm gonna quickly try and starch it and pop these papers out. I really want to get that far. I know we're getting late again, so we might go a few minutes over. Ooh, I think I feels like I almost broke my fabric or my thread there, but I think we're still good. We are still good. Uh-oh, my thread's about to fall out of here again. There we go. Saved it. Make a time. Alright, so here's going to be my last knicker knot. I'm going to go through it once, like a normal whip stitch, and then through again, stopping halfway, part the thread that's the fabric from right to left underneath, and then in the eye, we're going to go I got one of those knots. So here's those knots again, where it looks like it's, here's those knots that I'm talking about. It looks like, there we go, a little loop. So if you stick your needle right in that loop and kind of pull up, the knot kind of wants to go towards the needle. And once it's tight against the needle, then you can take the needle out. And I always just stick the needle underneath and it pops it right out. All right, finishing the knicker knot. And there we go. I'm going to just weave in the end a little bit here. And there we go. I know, I was thinking that too. He looks like he's flying through this field of flowers. And like it looks like a bunch of stars up here or something. He's flying through the field and the stars. I think that just turned out so sweet. Like unexpected. But all right, here is our flower. Let me trim off that other end. So yay, we were able to finish this all in one night, and that's probably because we glue basted it. The glue basting makes it go a lot quicker. So he'll live, let's see, he lives diagonally like this. So we're getting so close to the edge here, I might scooch it. I don't know, it is kind of centered with it, his bottom chin a little bit. But first, let's, maybe some of the brighter colors should go up top there, or like this really white color. Like that. Maybe like that. I think I kind of like that. I think it pops a little bit more. I like this. All right, I'm claiming this is it. So, all right, let's, I want to press it really quickly. I'm going to starch it. Here's my horrible iron. You know what? I think before we start the bunny kit, I'm going to have to get a new ironing board. It's getting all warped. It's pretty gross. I think it's time. And the bunny stitch along will be a good excuse, I think. I'll put it on my target list. All right, so I'm just doing my best press to spray. Uh-oh. Alexa, stop! Oh my god, that thing's gonna kill me. I swear. It just started singing. Last time I talked to you guys a couple days ago, she wanted to put crab on my shopping list, my non-existent shopping list. Oh man, crazy thing! All right, I think my iron's been sitting here, so it's still warming up. So by pressing this with the starch, it's gonna hold our edges. It'll hold our edges while we take the paper pieces out. I'm trying to find dry spots on my ironing board. And the ironing should be kind of drying it out a little bit too. It's a little damp yet, but I think we might be okay. So, all right, let's just do it. So now I'm going to pop out all the little papers and then we'll position it and glue it down. And then tomorrow we will stitch it down just like how we stitched this B down. And you will yell at your, I can't even say it out loud because it'll talk to me again like a bad dog. I know, it's so funny. Your board made it through the year. It did. Lots of starch and lots of ironing. Yep, that's what made it go crazy. All right, so let's pop these guys out. You know what, is a hair damp. I'm a little nervous to pop them out with the damp because it won't hold. The starch will make all my folds go away if it's wet yet. Yeah, I know. It's time for a new board though, isn't it? It's pretty gross. It didn't start getting like this until I started using the starch though, so it must really have something to do with spraying all that gook. Okay, so here we go. Let's pop these guys out. So because we punched that hole in at the beginning, it should be pretty easy. However, we did glue it all down, so I think the glue is what's going to keep us there. I've just been using my scissors. It doesn't really have a big point. If you're using something that could poke through your fabric, you don't want to use that. Use something dull, like a pin or something. But there we go. Pop it out. Perfect. So that's what the hole is for, why we punch the holes. You can get your device in there and just kind of pry it out. Ooh, but here, see it popped. Got a little bit of paper in there. But because we starched this, my little edges should be okay. Yeah, see, look, we just were able to fold those back in. Great. All right, let's pop these other ones out quick. Only a little late tonight. You know, I think I gotta try and undo some of this glue. There you go, pry out some of this glue. Wasn't popping out very easily. Ooh, it wants to hold there. Okay. You might have a tiny little bit of paper and stuff in there yet, but they seem to be, because we just starched it, they seem to be popping back pretty easily. Especially even when we pull them out like crazy there. Yeah, great. They're totally just folding right back in place. All right, three more. We'll glue it down and we'll be done for the day. And again, you guys, watch your emails tomorrow if you are on my, if you are getting my bunny emails and if you downloaded that free embroidery stitch guide. Make sure you check your emails tomorrow. And if you didn't download that yet, you can find it. I sent some emails about it. Otherwise, you can go to the new Bunny Facebook page that we made. It is, if you do a search on Facebook for Penguin and Fish Bunny Live Stitch Along, so type in Penguin and Fish, Bunny Live Stitch Along. If you start typing in Penguin and Fish, it'll pop up. But there will be a link for the free, in the doc section and in one of the posts, there'll be a link for the free embroidery stitch along, or the free embroidery cheat sheet. And there, that will get you onto the bunny list as well. So there will be an email going out tomorrow morning on there though. Just so you guys know, this feels like it has quite a bit of glue on. I gotta pick it out of here. Come on, guy. There we go. All right. Last little guy. I think. Oh, he's got kind of weird right here. Hold it up. Weird. Okay, so I'm going to just give him one little last press, but here is our flower without any papers anymore. It feels like fabric again, which is awesome. It's always fun to pop those papers out. Let's just squish them. Now, I'm not going to starch it now, because if I got it wet again, all of my edges would come out, because they would get all loose and unfold themselves, so you don't want to get it wet again. And then, how did we say, kind of like white. Was it kind of like that, or like that? I think that was cute. I like it like that. So, all right, I'm going to just put some glue around the edge of this just to hold it down, you know, overnight, and then just roughly, just enough to hold it in place, and then we'll hand applique this on tomorrow. Just like how we went all the way around, it's kind of like needle turn applique, but we've already turned it, right? All our edges are turned under right away, which is cool. So I'm trying not to get it on the center area. I'm trying to just keep it on the seam allowance, because then it'll float off of the back still. We don't want it to look like our, you know, the front is glued down. How about right there? It does have this one edge is lined up with the edge there. So we'll just do it how it's shown in the picture. You know, this is awfully close to the seam. We might chop off this flower a little bit. Let's put it right. We're gonna lose a seam allowance there too. Right there. I think why don't we move on to the hand next. We'll do some embroidery again. We'll probably get that started tomorrow already, because this will only take, you know, 10 minutes, maybe a little longer than that, maybe like a half hour. But yeah, I think we'll start that. But look, we're almost there. This is what we can finally see what it's gonna look like. Just gotta stitch that down. Crazy, so silly. Such a silly block. I like it. It's cute. I think I'm not gonna. I was thinking about maybe stitching around the edge and adding some feet, but I don't think I'm gonna. I'm gonna just leave it just like this. And, you know, we'll just stitch that around tomorrow. So, all right, guys, I'm gonna flip you around and we will call it a night. There, hey guys, thanks for hanging out with me a few minutes longer. I'm like, what's in the back? But I forgot we did these white stitches. But there, little bee, little flower. Yep, so we still had that little flower to do on this one. So we'll get that stitched down tomorrow, and I think let's start another one. Ooh, it's way over there. We'll count how many I have left tomorrow. I think it's 5, though. So we'll finish this one and get going on that hand. The hand, I feel like I can only take like a couple nights to finish. I don't think it's going to be like a whole giant, big Saturday thing like how the bee was to get it done. But yeah, we will finish him up and do the hand tomorrow. So, all right, guys, thank you so much again for coming in. I love hanging out with you guys in the evenings here. It's the best. Again, take a look at your emails for tomorrow and get on that, sign up for those bunny emails if you haven't done that yet before tomorrow. And I will see you tomorrow, guys. Thanks again for coming in, and I'll get this up on YouTube at Penguin and Fish Movies, and it will stay here on Facebook as well. Have a great night. I will see you guys tomorrow. Good night.